Hi, Toronto. I'm Abby.
And I'm Larena.
And we are here to tell you about your tap water.
Where does water come from? People use water every day for cooking, cleaning, washing, and bathing. When you're thirsty, you turn on the tap and cool, clean water gushes out. Are you surprised? Probably not, but have you ever stopped to think about where that water comes from or how it gets to you? For instance, did you know that we're using the same water that dinosaurs used millions of years ago?
Okay, it's not exactly the same, but that's only because it's been recycled over and over again in a process called the water cycle.
The water cycle works like this. The sun evaporates water from the Great Lakes, and the wind moves it high up in the air.
When water moves into the air, it forms clouds and falls as rain or snow.
Some rain, or melted snow, is soaked into the ground. What doesn't soak in runs off into streams and rivers and goes back to the lake. Here in Toronto, we get our drinking water from Lake Ontario. It is one of the largest and cleanest freshwater lakes in the world. But it is not clean enough to drink.
Before it reaches your house or apartment, it has to be cleaned.
How do we clean it? Water is collected from the lake. Large pipes located up to 83 meters below the surface of the lake and 1 to 3 kilometers offshore collect water. The water is pumped to one of 4 water treatment plants in Toronto.
At the entrance of the plant, big screens are used to remove large objects, like twigs, from the water.
Then, chlorine is added to kill the bacteria and germs.
Alum is added to the water.
Alum makes the dirt in the water stick together. We call this process coagulation.
Then the water is gently mixed so that the small clumps form larger lumps. These big lumps are called flock. The flock settles to the bottom of large tanks called settling tanks.
From the settling tanks, the water flows through the filters.
These filters are made from very simple things: anthracite or carbon, sand and gravel.
These filters remove any dirt that might be left in the water.
After the filters do their cleaning, a little bit more chlorine is added to the water. This is used to kill any remaining bacteria and germs so that the water is absolutely safe for you to drink.
We also add a little bit of fluoride to the water because it helps to reduce cavities in everyone's teeth. The last thing we need is ammonia. It makes sure that the chlorine stays dissolved in the water, which still has a long way to go before it gets to you.
So now the water is clean. What happens next? Somehow we need to get that water to you. The cleaned water is pumped through big pipes to pumping stations where it can be sent all over the city.
We need to clean and pump enough water for over 2.8 million people in Toronto. We also send water to Markham, Richmond Hill, and Vaughan in York Region.
That's a lot of water.
The city also has 10 water reservoirs, huge concrete buildings built right into the ground where extra water is stored just in case. The roofs are sloped and they are covered with earth and grass, so they make good places to play games, walk your dog, or just relax.
There are also 4 big steel storage tanks above the ground. The reservoirs and tanks are especially important during emergencies, like fires, for example. When there is a fire, the fire department will use a lot more water than a family at home will. So they use water from these storage areas.
The cleaned water travels under the city in pipes called water mains. There are almost 5,500 kilometers of water mains in Toronto, some big and some small. Water mains are made of steel, lined with cement, and covered in concrete. Some of the older pipes are made of cast iron. The pipes take the water under main roads. They are connected to smaller pipes, which are connected to even smaller pipes that carry the water right into your house or apartment. Some sections of the water main pipes are 80 to 100 years old. They've given decades of great service, but some parts need to be replaced or repaired. The city is working hard to replace the old pipes.
We are here at the high-level pumping station. It's really noisy.
We're standing on one of the original 100-year-old pumps. They don't use these anymore.
Making sure that the water flows properly through all those pipes is a big job. A giant computer system provides information on water pressure, how much water is in the storage reservoirs and tanks, and the amount of water that the city is using.
Our water tastes great.
Yeah.
Besides cleaning the water, storing the water, and pumping it to you, the City of Toronto is also responsible for making sure that your water is safe to drink. We check the water 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. We test the water hundreds of thousands of times per year. That's a lot of testing.
Every person in Toronto, including you, uses almost 250 liters of water per day for things like doing laundry, taking a bath, and watering the lawn.
Wow!
That's a lot of water.
The good news is, there are lots of ways to save.
Toilets are the biggest water guzzlers. Here's a simple test you can do to check for leaks. Get an adult to help lift the cover off the toilet tank and add a drop or two of food coloring. Don't flush, wait a minute or two, and then check the toilet bowl water to see if it's changed color. If it has, then you have a leaky toilet. Fix it or replace it with a low flush toilet. They use a lot less water.
There are other ways to save water in the bathroom too. Take a short shower instead of a bath, and remember to shut off the tap while you brush your teeth.
If your family needs a new dishwasher or a new washing machine, they can buy special water and energy efficient ones. In the summertime, we use even more water than other times of the year.
When it starts to get hot outside, the amount of water used in the city increases by about 60%.
We use enough water to fill the Rogers Center 1.5 times each day. We use this to water our lawns and gardens, wash our cars, and fill our pools.
You may have a lawn. Did you know that your lawn needs less water than you think? It only needs to be watered 2 or 3 times a week for 20 minutes. That's it.
There are other ways you can save water. Find a broom and sweep your driveways and walkways instead of hosing them down with water. Remember to cover your swimming pool when it's not being used. This will reduce the amount of water that evaporates into the air. Set up a rain barrel to collect rainwater and use it to water flower beds and lawns and to wash the car or even the dog. Check for leaks on outdoor taps.
The next time you turn on a tap to get a drink of water or brush your teeth, think of the long, long journey your water has taken from Lake Ontario to your home.
If we all use a little less water, the city has to spend less money on providing water, which means they can spend more money on working to repair and replace the older parts of the system
to keep it in tip-top shape for years to come.